is present in countries of every continent of the planet. Churches in countries of the three Americas, Europe, Africa, Asia, and Oceania, all connected by the same doctrine and the direction of the Holy Spirit of God, and united by the living Word. Our brothers and sisters in all parts of the world participate of the same service together, in the same body, in the same spirit. Through the transmission system, the members of Maranatha Christian Church around the planet are living a time of unity and fellowship, as the Hebrews lived at the time of their departure from Egypt, and the disciples of the Lord Jesus lived at the eve of his death on the cross at Calvary. People from all over the world have been reached by the eternal gospel and by the message that the Lord Jesus is coming soon.
I'd like to greet all with the peace of the Lord Jesus. We are beginning now Sunday Bible School of Maranatha Christian Church. It's a great joy to count with the participation of all. And yes, the participation, because this service, which we will be putting before our God, it's made so that all can participate. You in your home, wherever you may be watching, you will be participating and glorifying the name of the Lord. And in a special way, I'd like to greet those who received a link, an invitation via a link to watch this transmission. You're welcome. And it's a pleasure to have your audience and your participation. The Lord has a blessing for your life, the direction of the Holy Spirit of God for you. You will know, get to know today what is the revelation of the Lord for His church. And we will begin the service with a prayer to invoke. And I'd like to tell you who are visiting us, who arrived here today, received this link. And if you'd like, you can accompany us in this gesture in kneeling down, but you can stay at your leisure if you desire. But I invite the church at this moment to kneel down for this prayer, for this pleading by the blood of the Lord Jesus. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we plead by the power that's in the blood of the Lord Jesus. We put our lives before you, recognizing our sin, knowing, Lord, that we are flawed and imperfect. We confess to you at this time our sins. And we ask, Lord, that, O Lord, covered by the blood of the Lord Jesus, your Holy Spirit can act in our hearts, in our lives, in our minds. O Lord, bringing us to an experience of intimate fellowship with you. And we ask that from this moment on, your name may be glorified in the life of each person that is participating in this service. And we ask that we may reach your portion, your teaching, the spiritual growth that you have for us this morning. We ask that you may bless us and be with us. We plead by the blood and by the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. All may be seated. And right now we will be singing a song to the Lord. And this song that will be played, it will have in the images, the lyrics written, it will be projected. And you may be singing alongside, accompany the families that are watching. Your entire family can be praising and worshiping the Lord's name. And right after this song, we will have the first part of this Sunday Bible School, a word from the president of Maranatha Christian Church, Pastor Gedeo Chigueiros. Let's praise the Lord.
As we begin our Sunday Bible School today, we want to greet all those who are following us or listening to us with the holy peace of the Lord. First of all, we want to refer to the situation which many of our brethren are living, which brings us sadness and distress. This week, we had 5 brethren who died. And this makes us sad, and we tell those who are praying to keep praying. We tell our brethren that at this time, we need to redouble our care. There is a tendency to believe that things will change with the passing of time, but they won't. They won't because we're not dealing with something whose feelings can be moved. The virus does not care about our suffering. Absolutely. And there's something more: euphoria, excitement, laws, decrees, none of this will change the situation which we have to face. We need to be realistic. Those who are able to keep safe, do it. Avoid contamination from people who live in the same house, family members who get sick. Be careful. We have situations today that bring us concern. Children taking care of parents, parents taking care of children who are infected. This is what we see. The virus can easily be transported. It has the ability to infect people. No matter how much people pay attention and seek protection. But keep safe as best as you can when you buy stuff. Fulfill obey the orientations, and be careful with those who need help in any situation. But the sadness really brings us down. We can also say that in Europe, or rather abroad, the number of people infected is not increasing, but the number of people healed is increasing. This is abroad. We only have 14 people sick and 3 deaths, while in Brazil we have 768 people sick, 960 healed, 1,700, we could say 1,790 people infected in round numbers, and we have 60 deaths. This is sad. May the brethren who are hearing us, and some even living this moment of loss, a situation, circumstances which are totally different from a normal death, when you can follow, have a service, you have a people surrounding you, even in the most difficult moment, which is the funeral. But we are living what we have, and we cannot avoid it. This is our word and our sorrow. I know. Please, those who are praying, continue to pray, intercede, and keeping safe from this moment that can come to anyone. With respect to the event which we had, the trumpets and feasts, we now have a picture that is displayed, 132,770 visitors, and an average of 31.48 visitors per church. But I would also like to talk about the results, and they are there on the screen. Pastors who produced according to the state. São Paulo is back in first place with 1,068 visitors. With two churches in first place. Second place is Rio de Janeiro again, with 1,058 people. The results are coming during the week. Minas Gerais in third place, 696. Pernambuco, 694. Bahia, 655. And Espírito Santo, 592. Paraíba, Ceará, Rio Grande do Sul, all working. This is the reality, an extraordinary work. And according to states, we have the numbers of other states which we didn't cover. We had São Paulo with 106.45%. Second place, Rio Grande do Sul, which is a blessing for us. Roraima, also, 98, almost 100%. Sergipe made big advances, and we glorify the Lord for the work by the brethren in Sergipe, Piauí, Ceará, Rio de Janeiro, Paraná, Santa Catarina, Pernambuco, Amazonas, Rio Grande do Norte. See, brethren, the work which had positive results. And we understand that everything that was done was with great effort, because we didn't have the participation of all of our people because of lack of knowledge how to deal with technology and means to communicate. We have perhaps 40 to 60% of brethren who cannot even follow us in the social networks. Today, we're improving our communication because we have TV networks like TVNet, Brazil TV, the environmental TV in the state of Espírito Santo, Capixaba TV from Bandeirantes Network, several TV networks or stations which are working with us, transmitting the messages which are now being transmitted, reaching a larger area of the states. Regions which before were not reached, now they are being reached. We have a large group that is interacting with us and integrating with us. And not only that, but there is a large network being formed besides Rádio Manaim. There are several other radios in Brazil, and we are in contact with other radio stations, and soon we'll have a large network of radio stations nationally and internationally. And an additional observation, which is very important for our brethren. Today we have TVs transmitting to 180 countries, TV stations from Ukraine and Russia. They reach people that speak Russian and similar languages. And in Israel, we have 20% of the population that speak Russian, also being reached by a TV network. We have a large group which is increasing every day in number of TV stations in the United States as well as in Panama, and soon we'll have almost every country in South America and some in Central America reached by TV stations, and will reach homes and several places in the world. I also want to say that during the transmission of Trumpets and Feasts, we received a blessing to be able to transmit through an Italian TV station, which reaches between 10 and 15 million people. That's their reach. I'm not saying that 10 or 15 million people attended or watched the program, but the program was transmitted there, and this is a great miracle from God. Normally, in Italy, and in particular Rome, it's very difficult to find an opportunity to transmit a Christian message in TV networks. I also want to talk about not only the work of the brethren, but the work abroad. For example, Quito and another city in Ecuador, more than 70 people were reached through the invitations, and others are still being reached, not only there, but also in Brazil, because our people didn't stop inviting, sending the link, and they will continue. And we are having a result of 90%. When we send the link, in particular for the Trumpets and Feasts, we have a very large participation of our friends, relatives, neighbors, people near us, and even far abroad. So that you may have an idea, we have approximately, on a monthly basis, we have almost 6,000 phone calls that we receive from those who are watching our programs. More than 6,000 calls per month. Calls to the presbytery, and we had to increase the number of people in the call center. We have an average on a daily basis of 166 people that every day call our 0800 number asking for prayer, for help, people who are deciding, committing, and there's a large number of people saying, we are back. This past week, we had the participation of a friend from Rio de Janeiro who has a large family, and he said that he was back. And he was asking us if we accepted them. And we said, you are accepted. with an open heart. We know your life, your testimony, and your way of behaving. And he explained how somebody else had disturbed his walk with the Lord. It's like this. It's trials that we all face. But we will continue this battle in prayer, in pleading. And we have, in fact, today, so that you have an idea, more than 900, almost 10,000 people participating and sending contributions for the Sunday Bible School. This is wonderful, and it's remarkable for us. In first place, we have Rio de Janeiro, and then Minas Gerais, São Paulo, fourth place, Espírito Santo, fifth, Bahia. Not only in Brazil, but we had more than 40 or 50 contributions or countries from abroad, United States, Bolivia, Argentina, Italy, England, Portugal. And we are now getting ready to receive contributions from Africa. We're also getting ready to do an analysis of the content that is being received, all the contributions, which are extremely rich. Today, Pastor Gilson is going to give some answers to questions which were asked in the previous meeting that we had of the Sunday Bible School, linked to Samson's riddle. There are wonderful answers. The great problem, the big problem for us is that we were not ready to receive this great number of contributions. But we are getting ready to have this set of information and revelations, which are extraordinary. They are coming from all our people, the participation of our brethren. They are evangelizing. They are understanding a revealed work. This is the great secret of the work, the revealed word. Soon, we will be finishing here this part of announcements, but we would still like to remind you that we are... Let me change my glasses so that I can read better. We have a report from a sister, Andrea Talma. She sent a report concerning the indigenous communities which are watching our programs in their region. Pastor Flavio Ximenes. She's talking about the cities of Pacaraima and Boa Vista, where we have some of our churches. There is a group of Indians in Boca da Mata, Aleluia, and Fonte Nova, in the state of Roraima. And we have brethren who are there in the rural area of Boa Vista. The tribes are Makuxi and Chapixama. And there is a sister who is a teacher of children. She is Makuxi. And the husband is a worker and Vapishama. So these are from our beloved pastor, Flavio Ximenes. She's talking about the support, the spiritual and material support that the Maranatha Christian Church gives through the international mission, the International Maranatha Christian Mission. It is connected to the Maranatha Christian Church, and many people don't know. The goal is to promote assistance to the brethren who are in need. We have another information concerning the reception of the internet services. Each community supported by us is receiving the programs. There is the Boca da Mata community participating in the services through cell phones. They are isolated today because of the situation, restrictions imposed by the government, and that is natural. But the brethren are supporting them with food staples, everything that is possible, all the types of assistance possible. They are sharing the difficulty to interact with us through the internet and open TV. There are difficulties in the area. But on the other hand, on a daily basis, they receive the services of the early morning transmitted by Rádio Manaim. Glory be given to the Lord. And the 8 p.m. services via YouTube when the transmission improves. They also talk about the experience of the teacher of the community. He and his wife had the virus, but they are already healed. There's the community called Alleluia, which is totally isolated. They do not have TV signal or internet or cell phones. They tried to have access, but they were not successful. And the Maranatha Christian Church installed a power supply so that they may receive TV signal or signal satellite signal on Monday, Saturday, Sunday, and Sunday Bible School. They were also participating in in-person services. Community Alleluia depends totally on the Maranatha Christian Church, and it's 98 kilometers away from the road. Not always they can access the community, which is being assisted. There is also the tribe in Fonte Nova, which participates on the services through TV and internet. We had to install power supply there a few weeks ago and a TV set so that the members could watch TV or services through the internet. They have TV signal and are watching the program announcing the eternal gospel on Sundays. So to finish, Pastor Flavio says that three families are sick with malaria, but they are being medicated. And in Fonte Nova, these brethren are being assisted for 5 years now. So this is the work, the support given by the International Maranatha Christian Mission, so that the gospel be proclaimed, announced, and that the brethren are appropriately supplied. Signed, Andrea Talma. May the Lord bless the sister. Now, I will stop now and come back in a few moments to begin our Sunday Bible school. Peace of the Lord be with you all.
Forth as the dawn of a new day. She's fair as the moon, as bright as the sun. She is awesome as an army flying banners. I went down to the grove of nut trees to see the blossoms that grow in the valley, to see whether there were buds on the vines, and pomegranates were in flower. For I knew it, my soul set me on the chariots of my noble people. Oh, return, O Shulamite. Oh, return, return, that we may look upon you. Why do you want to look at the Shulamite dawn? The dance of Shulamite, oh return,
Well, brethren, once again, the peace of the Lord. We are back to address the topic that will be covered today by the Sunday Bible School, still about Samson's riddle. People who do not know what revelation in the Word is, they have lots of difficulty, just like any other, even those who know that there is revelation in the Word. Of course, following all the historic and prophetic project of that which is God's program for the world and for man, and which is in the Holy Scriptures. When we began to discover that in the Old Testament there was a story that was hidden, that was a result of a revelation. In revelation, sometimes you have a part of the revelation, but not the rest. And we reached part of the revelation when we discovered Samson's riddle. What is sweeter than honey, and what is stronger than a lion? There is an extraordinary teaching here. What is sweeter than honey? You can say it's what comes from inside the Lord Jesus, from his heart. It's the sweetness that his death brought about when he gave himself to die to rescue us. That was his great love for us. So that lion became the lamb, which was the figure of Jesus. What is sweeter than honey, and what is stronger than the resurrection? When we get those two aspects, we can see what the death was, the ministry of the Lord Jesus as man was up to death. And now his figure as God, it was his resurrection. And the Word of God says that he was glorified through his resurrection. And now the project is no longer in the world here. It is in eternity, but carried out in the world by the Holy Spirit. Human figures that appear and disappear in the riddle, in the mystery, are natural. They are not fixed. They walk within the revelation. I am not going to dwell on many things today, because the topic was already dealt with, and the brethren sent several contributions. I'm going to say the following. We saw a history in the text, the figure of Jesus as the riddle that the world could not explain. Israel, in particular, could not explain. The sons of my people could not explain it. Then we will see that there is a history there of the church prophesied in the Old Testament. And that is important for us because we see our history, the history of our last days as church and the departure for eternity. Then we will see the time revealed in the riddle pointing to the prophetic moment of the church's departure. We are living this time. We're not saying that Jesus will come today, tomorrow, after. It's not our problem. The problem, what is prophetic is clearly in the prophecy. It's the Kairos, not the Chronos. We cannot measure one with the other. Our reach is relative. But it's that which matters for the church living her moment in this time or in any time. But the time now is turned toward the period in which the church is preparing for the rapture. What brought us up to here is one thing. It's a history. We're in the wedding feast, but now it's the time of the departure. The wedding is going to close with the riddle explained. So this is the sunset of the seventh day. The work is perfect. Seven speaks about the perfection of the work, its completeness. The sunset, the period of darkness, when a new day will dawn. When it talks about sunset, it's not 6, 7 p.m. It can be in Brazil, in Japan, anywhere in the world. Sunset is a prophetic expression that speaks of the time of the history of the church in the world, in God's project for His church, anytime. That is clear. So sunset, it may be midnight in Japan, in China, in Brazil, but that's not how it works. Revelation is not that which you reach by reason. If you come with reason, you totally lose the sequence of the revelation. You're going to find many people questioning and saying, but I want to know, who is going to question this riddle, death and resurrection? Only those who do not understand. They will think that death and resurrection is to go out with Jesus' coffin, walking back and forth. It's not ugly, it's not terrible, but that's not what God wants to show man. He wants to show His... Nobody needs to be sorry for Jesus because He died for us. Of course, we love Him because He did that for us. So this is more or less explained. Where do I want to go? Where the brethren have not arrived yet. So let's come to chapter 14, verse 16 of Judges. Then Samson's wife wept on him and said, "You only hate me. You do not love me. You have posed a riddle to the sons of my people Israel, but you have not explained it to me." And he said to her, "Look, I have not explained it to my father, to his father," meaning that the secret, the mystery is with him, or my mother, Israel. I haven't declared. So should I declare it to you, church? That is merely in the wedding feast, in the beginning. Will I already say to you what it means, the riddle concerning Jesus, this riddle that I am proposing? Show the next verse, verse 17. Now she had wept on him the 7 days. Brethren, now it is the church. The church is before him celebrating the wedding, the preparation, the feast for the encounter later on. And it happened on the 7th day that he told her, who explains the riddle, Jesus, is not something that history tells about him. He who explains the riddle is the Holy Spirit. Jesus is revealed by the Holy Spirit. If Jesus is not revealed, you may organize the feast you want, you may add the excitement you want. He needs to be revealed to man. Man doesn't change his walk unless there's an operation of the Holy Spirit in his life. And those who have this experience do not dwell on details of what he does not understand. So revelation is for all those who want to know the mystery. The mystery is not with the Christian, Maranatha Christian Church or the pastor. The mystery is a gift of the Holy Spirit for those who believe the Lord Jesus. and who are in this wedding feast in the moment of the departure. That's the moment we are living. Let's show verse 18. So the men of the city said to him on the seventh day, that is, in the last hour comes the explanation. Before the sunset, the midnight cry, what is sweeter than honey? This is the experience that the church is having at this hour, the resurrection of Jesus, his power, his grace, his mercy, everything that he is, the love that he has for us. And he said to them, Samson, the Holy Spirit, if you had not plowed my heifer, you would not have solved my riddle. When man is not within the context, the body of the Christ, the Church of Christ, he will never be able to explain the riddle. He may be a teacher, a dean, whatever he wants in life, and even show on social media that he's very important. But no importance is going to prevent this great work, the mystery of Jesus in the life of man, in my life, in your life, which can happen in your life if you open your heart. Don't stick to reason, willing to question that which is the world's need at this time, to know Jesus as the Savior, the one who's going to come to rapture his church ready for the departure. What is referred to in the Revelation, the beginning of sorrows, is the period of struggles of the church. Some have already gone to the Lord, but now it's the moment where the church fulfills her mission and is going to go as a set altogether. It's not an individual. We're not talking about the virus. We're talking about the invitation for the wedding feast. Then the Spirit of the Lord, and this is very important, came upon him mightily of Samson, and he went down to Ashkelon and killed 30 of their men, took their apparel, and gave the changes of clothing to those who had explained the riddle. And the text says, so his anger was aroused, and he went back up to his father's house. He's referring to the Holy Spirit, the operation of the Holy Spirit, that which is going to happen. Those who explain the riddle are going to receive the benefits of those who are here and could not declare or explain the riddle. It's a tribulation. They will pay the price. The church will receive the benefits of having explained the riddle, and those who could not declare will be deprived of the benefits of salvation. All right? The changes of clothing will be taken away from them. They have no right to salvation. Those who do not explain the riddle do not have the benefit of salvation. These are not my words. Let's go on. So his anger was aroused, and he went back up to his father's house. The Holy Spirit has completed his mission. He's gone. Did he go by himself? Yes. And who kept the bride? The text says, and Samson's wife was given to his companion, who had been his best man. Who was with the Holy Spirit? Jesus. Who was next to Eliezer, who took Rebekah? Who was waiting? Isaac. The Holy Spirit fulfills his mission, and the church is going to go up. And the Holy Spirit went. He is the leader of the church. Eliezer came and took Rebekah. He went away. Did he stay living in Rebekah's house? Did he stay living in Isaac's house? No. The Holy Spirit, Samson, gives to his best man the bride who is going to go and will leave for her journey. So, brethren, we are going to stop here because there's much to be learned. And the brothers say, well, I didn't know this, but there's more. There are other revelations concerning Israel. Samson returns. So there's a long history here, but we need discernment. You need revelation. For the smart ones who like to question, it is time to show from now on the revelation. We will have the opportunity to continue bringing the revelations which are in the text. I will now transfer the floor to Pastor Gilson, who is going to give sequence to this study, bringing the answers that brethren from Brazil and the world sent to us. He's going to make a selection. And within a few days, we'll, on Mondays and Tuesdays, show the DVDs that are coming, all the recordings of testimonies we're going to show on Mondays and Tuesdays when we are better organized. You'll have the opportunity to glorify the Lord. And today we will see a young lady from Turkmenistan. And here we have a list of brethren from the former Soviet Union who were in a meeting this week with Pastor Alexandre and Pastor Gilson. From Russia, Ukraine, Moldova, Belarus, Latvia, Lithuania, Armenia, Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, Georgia, Finland, Israel, Spain, Croatia, Poland, Canada, United States, brethren. You will see this young lady from Turkmenistan. We are everywhere in the world. We have a group of from youth from India sending contributions. The work is for those who want, those who are happy, who ate honey and are satisfied. If you ate honey and are satisfied, eat what is enough for you. Some people think they know enough, they know too much, but we're showing it's a time for preparation. And I would like to say also that the Lord raised 11 pastors in Poland who are interested in this work. And it's not only Poland. Pray for the world, the work abroad. We have some names here. Bishops from Goroni, Novgorod, other pastors, Ruman, Vladivostok, also in Central Asia, Anatoly, Kachenko, Samara, Bishop Abel, Pavel, and many others, Croatia, Poland, brethren. The work is open to the world. If it closed for your life, it's your problem. But for a new people, it's being opened. And we want to follow the people that is with us. Beloved, I will transfer the floor to Pastor Gilson. And at the end, we're going to ask the questions for next Sunday. May God bless you all. Keep praying and sharing the link of our Sunday Bible school services and trumpets and feasts, because the work of the church is not finished. The work of evangelism. Peace of the Lord.
I'd like to greet the brothers with the peace of the Lord Jesus. We are here to continue on with our Sunday school, and we are going to give you the answers to the questions that were made on the previous Sunday school, which was the Enigma of Samson, for this Sunday school. And we'd like to thank all those that participated throughout Brazil and abroad. We've had 844 participations of those that sent in messages collaborating with their studies. And these are going to be the composition of this Sunday school. And this time, we've had many people participating there and sending their contributions from 27 states in Brazil and the federal district. They all participated in this Sunday school. And also, we'd like to mention those in Rio de Janeiro. They were in front of everyone else with their contributions, also Minas Gerais, São Paulo, Bahia, and the other states that collaborated. And from abroad, we had 59 participants, 44 churches in 16 countries, and they sent, even beyond these informations, they've also sent videos, many videos, about 15 videos in foreign languages and 10 in the Portuguese language. And we're joyful with this participation, and we're going to go to our first question here, the answer this morning. Reading here. Read the text in Judges 14, verses 5 and 6, and identify what represents the figures of Israel and the Trinity? Israel and the Trinity. The one that'll give the answer on this will be our brother in Italian, Arturo Siviani. He is one of the youth in Treviso in Italy, Pastor Gilberto Pereira. He will give this answer.
Gesù è rappresentato per la figura del leone, non solo perché lui è molte volte riferito come il leone della tribù di Giuda, ma anche perché lui fu sacrificato per la nostra salvezza, perché lui è l'unica persona che sa la risposta del mistero, ma anche perché Dio invia il suo unico figlio, Gesù, perché morisse per noi. Così come succede in questi versetti. Sansone uccide il leone, che è la figura di Gesù. Lo Spirito Santo è rappresentato semplicemente per la figura dello Spirito del Signore. Israele è rappresentato per tutti quelli che non sanno la risposta del mistero, che in questo caso sono i genitori di Sansone.
Very good, brothers. As the answer was given, there are a few things that you may have understood one way or another, because the question of figures and types, we have to be very careful, because a figure is related to that moment, what that person is representing in that prophetic aspect. So we see the figure of Israel and the parents of Samson, and the figure of the Trinity that shows the expression, the Spirit of the Lord in the figure of the Father, and the lion that was opened like a goat is like the Son Jesus, and also the figure of Samson. He is the Holy Spirit. Why is that? Let's explain this. Because the parents of Samson, they prefigured Israel in the Old Testament because they wanted Samson to get married with a daughter of their land. But they didn't know, in verse 4, they didn't know that that marriage with the Philistine was in the project of God. And what we also see is that Samson, he said they didn't know about what had happened with the lion. We see in verse 6, neither your father or mother were aware of what happened. And this shows the figure of Israel in the Old Testament who didn't understand the mystery or the secret or the enigma that's related to the Lord Jesus. And the Trinity, also the figure of the Father, we see the strength of the Lord, which came upon Samson. And that strength, which relates to the power that comes from the Father, because the power of the Lord in Samson is what took Samson and made him able to fulfill God's project for Israel in those days. And the figure of the Son, we see in the condition, in the lion who was opened. It is this represents the sacrifice of the Lord Jesus. And also, someone mentioned the Son, who was the enigma. He was the great mystery, and Jesus as well is the great mystery that's not known in the Old Testament, but Samson, also in the figure of the Holy Spirit, he is the one that proposes the enigma, and he is the one that is able to reveal the enigma. And there we see the answer. We'd also like to remember some of the participations from abroad in Argentina, San Cristobal, Pastor Daniel Oliveira. He said, even though the parents of Samson were with him, but they didn't know the reason and the facts the same way, Israel today isn't able to understand the project of salvation that's revealed by the death and the resurrection of Jesus. Also, there was a participation from Rio de Janeiro. Some of the youth there in Figueira, in Nova Iguaçu, Pastor Barreto, and they said, the death of the Son was hidden to the parents of Samson. Israel didn't see him as the Savior, but as they killed him and brought him to the cross, and this was a contribution by our brothers that participated in this study. There are other informations that we will be sharing on our site, and also the videos that'll be shared on our website with their collaborations. Let's go now to the second question. The second question says, summarize in two words the mystery of salvation that is in the answer of the riddle given by Samson. Cite the verse. And we can see here this new question. This will be answered in Russian. It will be answered in Russian by our youth, our sister Nikolina Yatluk. She is from the group of youth in Aktau in Kazakhstan and the Caspian Sea. And she will give this answer. And the pastor there is Pastor Andrei Yatluk.
Следующие два слова отвечают на заданный вопрос. Смерть и воскресение. Как написано в книге Судей, 14 глава, 18 стих. И в седьмой день до захождения солнечного сказали ему граждане, что слаще меда и что сильнее льва. Он сказал им, если бы вы не орали на моей телице, то не отгадали бы моей загадки. Прокомментируем. Великая тайна спасения, содержащаяся в ответе на загадку, заданную Самсоном в том, что представляет для нас смерть Господа Иисуса на кресте Голгофы и Его воскресение. Вся горечь нашего осуждения за грех была заменена на сладость, замещающую нас смерти Иисуса. Поэтому нет ничего слаще этого меда. И с другой стороны, воскрешение Господа Иисуса победило смерть. Он одержал триумф над смертью, воскреснув на третий день. Поэтому нет никого более сильного, чем лев из колена Иудина. Нет ничего слаще смерти Иисуса, умершего за наши грехи, и нет никого сильнее Иисуса, воскресшего для нашего оправдания.
Very good, brothers. You can see the answer of our sister. We don't need to have any comments because it was very clear. Speaking of the two words that were the key words that related to the mystery, the summary of the mystery that is in the enigma of Samson, of death and resurrection. There we can see she responded it very well. Let's also now transmit some of the participations. There was a contribution from in Marlborough, from Massachusetts, the project of salvation is based on the death and the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. And what is sweeter than honey? There is nothing sweeter than the death of Jesus on the cross and his sacrifice. And stronger than the lion, there's nothing stronger than the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. There's also another participation from another church in Rio de Janeiro. And this here, I'd like to call an attention to a group of the ladies in the region of Campo de Gringa, there in the region of Andros Reis, Pastor Oliveira. Their answer to this question they sent when they said, the love of Jesus brought him to go through death and to be victorious in his resurrection, to give us life as he died on the cross. The veil in the temple was torn from top to bottom, the same way that the lion was torn. And in his death came the honey, and in his resurrection we see the honey in the body of the lion. In Jesus, in his resurrection, we see the sweetness of the Holy Spirit in his blood that is life, and it has fed this body of Christ that is the faithful church. Very good. This is an answer. Now we are going to our third question. Let's look at the third question that says, identify and summarize the prophetic position of the church during the celebration of the wedding in the book of Judges, chapter 14, verses 16 and 17. Very good. This answer, we have now a participation from Rio de Janeiro from our sister, Karina. She is from our church in the Rocinha in Rio de Janeiro, Pastor Edilson. Our sister Karina will give the answer.
We understand that the position of the church is at the feet of the Lord, seeking to know its mysteries, to have intimacy, to know the intimacy of the Lord. We can draw a parallel between the seven wedding days presented here in the book of Judges with the seven prophetic periods of the church in the book of Revelation. Each church has experienced a prophetic and poetic moment. The church of Ephesus lived the doctrinal formation, the proclamation of the gospel. The church of Smyrna experienced the martyrdom of the faithful, the persecution. Now the church of Pergamum had the introduction of church paganisms, and Thyatira had a moment when the word was hidden. In Sardis, Luther discovers the living word. In Philadelphia, it's a period of revival. And in Laodicea, it's the last day of the feast. It's the time of soon. It's the final moment. It's the period in which the church lives now, and we understand that we are the church of the last day, the church that announces the return of Jesus. And we have a prophetic message for today, which is Maranatha, the Lord Jesus will come.
Very good, brothers. The prophetic position of the church in the period that she celebrated the wedding feast was exactly to cry at the feet of the Lord Jesus and receive from him the revelation of the mystery of Jesus. So the wife of Samson cried out at his feet, as the church throughout her existence in the seven prophetic periods of the church, crying out at the feet of the Lord and receiving the revelations during her existence. And that's the prophetic position of the church. It as the bride crying at the feet of Jesus throughout this whole period of the existence, as this was related to the book of the seven churches in Asia, as our sister answered. And I'd also like you to note, there was a participation of our brothers in Queimados, Paraíso, Pastor Eliezer da Silva. The participation says, Jesus is the enigma in the project of salvation because he can only be revealed through the operation of the Holy Spirit. For that reason, the position of the church is to depend and be at his feet throughout all of the period of the feast. It was a very clear, good explanation in Rio de Janeiro. Also in Costa Rica, they sent a marvelous explanation. The bride, she cries the 7 days before the bridegroom. And this is a moment of crying out, humility, fellowship, dependence, to know the enigma. And because of this attitude, he revealed himself and he revealed the mystery to the bride. How great is that? Let's go now to the fourth and last question. In our last question says, what were the guests lacking that didn't allow them to solve the riddle in 3 days? Cite the text. What did they lack so that they didn't solve the riddle in 3 days? We are going to receive this answer in English from England, our sister Deborah in Birmingham. Pastor Jean Carlos, she is going to give us this answer to this fourth and last question.
The guests did not have the patience and perseverance to decipher the riddle using threats and violence. In the same way, the world seeks to understand what is prophetical by reason and not by reaching the revelation. It says so in Psalm chapter 40, verse 1. I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined unto me and heard my cry.
Very good, brothers. Very clear, that answer of our sister, because they lacked. What did they lack? They wanted that the bride had to convince the bridegroom to declare this of using violence to understand, to burn the house of the bride. This shows the human resource when man uses the human resources to try to understand the mystery of Jesus. And this resource is reason. It's the resource of violence, of human reason, theology, the fourth dimension, everything that is part of the violence of man regarding his arguments to understand the mystery. That's why they couldn't understand it. And the other thing, the second thing, was in verse 18, when it says that she used my heifer. They used my heifer. They were only able to understand the mystery when they used the heifer. They didn't use the heifer prior, because the mystery of Jesus that's revealed to the world on the third day is exactly his resurrection. So working and using the heifer, this speaks of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus and the church and those that use the heifer. It speaks of the faithful church, those that are integrated into the body and those that are living with the body. And to those, the enigma or the riddle is understood through. The riddle that is understood through Jesus, this was only revealed on the third day. They stayed on the first day was death, the second day was death, and the third day, Jesus is alive and Jesus is resurrected. This is the great mystery of this riddle. And I'd also like to share, there was a word that was interesting from our brothers in Hallandale in Florida, Pastor Rogerio. The text says, the collaboration says, they lacked everything that represents fellowship, intimacy with the Lord, obedience, dependence, humility, and revelation. Also, our brothers in Rio de Janeiro, they also, in Marechal Capu, in Marechal, in the central region, Pastor Anderson, they said they lacked the revelation of the Holy Spirit for them, and they tried to use reason and violence to decipher this riddle, and that's why they couldn't understand what was prophetic. It was very clear, their answers, their participations that were sent to us, and we now have come to the end of this part of the Sunday School, and now we are going to continue praying in favor of the children's, intermediate, and adolescents, also the children from 0 to 3, and the ladies that are pregnant. Let's pray to the Lord now. We're going to ask you now to put your life before the Lord. If you would like to kneel, you may. And we are going to be praying, and God will be giving you a blessing. Let's pray to the Lord our God. O Lord God and Father, we plead to you by the power of the blood of Jesus at this time. In the act of laying on of hands, we ask you that you be blessing each child, each intermediate, each adolescent, and those children that are on their mother's laps, that you be blessing them, the young ones, that you be blessing them as they grow and they know more about the Lord in their participation in this Sunday school, in the teaching of your, in learning through your word. Also, our sisters that are pregnant, be keeping them, protecting them, and giving them a blessing in their spiritual life, in their physical life. We pray, trusting in your blessing, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Amen, brothers.
I want to greet everyone with the peace of the Lord Jesus. Last class, we said that we would show the children, intermediates, and adolescents playing their instruments. This work has reached many, and we know that those who have disabilities are just as capable. They have their abilities. Let's see them. This is Davi from São Gonçalo, Rio de Janeiro, an adolescent practicing his recorder. This is little Anna from Salvador, state of Bahia, playing her guitar. This is Gabi from the city of Vila Velha, Espírito Santo. Observe her attention to putting her fingers in the right spot. This is Davi, also from the city of Vila Velha in the state of Espírito Santo. Davi is an adolescent. He's practicing his recorder and also singing. What a blessing! How marvelous it is to see our children dedicating themselves in the work of the Lord. Send in your videos and pictures, and in another opportunity we'll be showing here in our program. So we are learning the facilitated version of the song In the Battles I Am a Winner. We have already learned the introduction, and today we will learn how to finish the song in an easier way. So to play, we will use the same music notes that we have already learned. Sol, La, Ti, Do, Re. So let's learn the facilitated ending of the song. The structure of the song, the tone, the type of measure will remain the same. So let's first read the notes. Sol, sol, sol. La, la, la. La, la, la. Ti, do, ti. Do, re, do. I am certain that you have noticed that the first, the second, and the third measures are just like the introduction. So we're going to have two parts that will be played faster. It's the 16th note. Ti do and do re. Let's take the advantage to learn one more sign, a symbol that we use in music. This curved line here is called a tie. It's a tie between two notes that prolongs the sound, the tempo. These two notes are at the same height, T and the other T. So the time will pass for this, but it will not be played. Let's play. This first time will be very slowly and with tranquility. 1, 2, 3, 4. To play along with the song, we have to play faster. Let's count. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we won't count and we'll wait to play along with the song. Very good. Keep practicing. Amen. And to everyone, the peace of the Lord Jesus. And until next class. We greet all the children, the adolescents, and all of those who are watching with the peace of the Lord Jesus. The theme of our class is the Living Word, and we will be studying the testimony of Samson. I invite that everyone read the verse that's projected on the slide. So he said to them, "Out of the eater came something to eat, and out of the strong came something sweet. Now for 3 days they could not explain the riddle." Judges chapter 14, verse 14. The Word of God tells us that before the birth of Samson, the people of Israel lived under the Philistines' rule for 40 years, and they prayed for someone to deliver them. So the Lord heard their cry, and he raised Samson as a deliverer and a judge of Israel. Samson was a servant of the Lord, and he had his life conducted by the Holy Spirit of God. Because of that, he was a winner. The Word also tells us about a difficult situation that Samson lived. When he was traveling, a lion came to meet him, and in that moment, Samson, without any weapons in his hands, he faced the lion through the blessing of the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit of God enabled him and filled him with this extraordinary strength. And with his bare hands, he was able to kill the lion. The Word says that days later, Samson goes back to that place and he sees the body of that lion. When he comes closer, he notices that there was a swarm of bees inside the lion's body, and they produced honey. Samson takes that honey and he goes back to his home, and he doesn't tell anyone what happened. After a few days, Samson's wedding feast begins. There were 7 days of celebration, and as a custom from that time, Samson proposes a riddle for his guests. There, his guests had to figure out what the riddle was until the 7th day of the feast. And he said, "Out of the eater came something to eat, and out of the strong came something sweet." But the Word of God tells us that by the 3rd day, no one had figured out the riddle. This class brings us a very interesting lesson. The Word of God tells us that on the 7th day, Samson's riddle was revealed. The answer was, "What is sweeter than honey? And what is stronger than a lion?" This to us means a great blessing, because the answer to this riddle pointed to Jesus. Jesus is the Lion of Judah, who was strong and conquered death and gave us the great blessing of providing us with the taste of sweetness of salvation, the sweetness of the great love of God. The Word says that until the 3rd day, no one had revealed the mystery, because the 3rd day tells us about a prophetic time. Jesus came to this world, fulfilled his ministry, died on the cross of Calvary, shedding innocent blood, and on the 3rd day he resurrected, so that the great mystery of the project of salvation of man could be revealed. And on the 7th day, Samson's riddle was revealed. The 7th day tells us about a perfect day, the day that we as a church will rise to meet Jesus in eternity. It's the rapture of the church. What a marvelous thing. The Word of God is full of mysteries that only the Holy Spirit can reveal to us. May this word stay in our hearts, and may we be attentive to what the Holy Spirit has revealed to his church. To everyone, the peace of the Lord Jesus.
You know, come to this
Praise be the name of the Lord. What a blessing when the children praise the Lord with a perfect praise. It's what the word tells us. And very well, we are arriving to the last part of the Sunday Bible School, and we will here transmit the questions for next Sunday. Exceptionally, the topic throughout this week, it will, in a punctual way, will be directed in a different topic, but we will continue in the sequence studying about Jesus in the Old Testament. So let's go to the questions for next Sunday. This is an introduction. So remembering some of the studies done in 2019. So if we're going back exceptionally this week, a theme that we studied in 2019 in the book of Nehemiah chapter 13, answer the following questions. So we will go back to studying the book of Nehemiah in chapter 13 this week exceptionally. So the question in sequence. So we're just awaiting the question. So we're returning here to the book of Nehemiah. And we are studying about the reconstruction of the walls of Jerusalem in the period of reconstruction for Israel. And naturally, everything that was lived there, the experiences, we're remembering that the reconstruction was right at the end of the project. So when the project was ending. So let's go to the question here. So looking back, so this is the first question. So it's four parts. So the first question is divided into four parts. So looking back to the sad ending history of Eliashib Priestley, his ministry. A, cite his disobedience, his acts of disobedience, and its results in his and his people's lives. So I'll repeat, cite his acts of disobedience and its results of these acts in his personal life and the lives of the people that were there under his care, under his ministry. B, summarize in a sentence with three words, what hastened the downfall of Eliashib's priestly ministry. So it's an expression, a sentence, a phrase with three words. What hastened the downfall of Eliashib's priestly ministry? So let's go to the third part, letter C. What spiritual gifts were abandoned by Eliashib in his ministry? And it's also asking here to cite the text. So he abandoned some spiritual gifts. What were they in his ministry? What spiritual gifts were abandoned by Eliashib in his ministry? And the last part, part D, in a practical sense, what has been the danger surrounding also the ministries in this work? Relate this to the history and the mistakes and the results in the lives of Eliashib and the people. So it's the practical sense. It's what Eliashib lived, the danger that surrounded his ministry in the moment that we're living in. So how does that relate to the moment that we're living in? What can we apply practically? So there were his mistakes. What are the dangers that we face today? So the pastors will be working with their youth workers, the ladies, studying these questions throughout this week. It's an opportunity because the teaching of Nehemiah, the book of Nehemiah, it's a very profound and marvelous study that resulted in messages, studies, marvelous studies that we had in the year of 2019. And we'll have the opportunity to revisit this, to this study throughout this week. And this will strengthen us and will show us some ways that the Lord wants to show us in this moment. So very well, last week, brothers, we spoke here about TV channels and Pastor Jidochi He reinforced this morning, and also about radio stations that are transmitting in Brazil our content. The services, the program announcing the everlasting gospel, the eternal gospel. So very quickly here, we're going to speak about the transmissions occurring overseas. So we have a Russian channel, TBN. It's broadcasting to Russia, Ukraine. It's a dubbed program, and it's being transmitted to three countries, so Russia, Ukraine, and Israel. And 25% of the population in Israel is from the old Soviet Union. So just clarifying that. So we have 25% of the population in Israel that understands the Russian language and receives and are receiving this transmission. So these three countries are receiving this transmission. And also the TBN reports that it's TBN in Russia, it's TBN Ukraine, and it's also Shalom TV in Israel. So also TBN reports that it reaches 186 countries via cable, satellite, and open TV. So this is information that TBN reported as well to us. And also in the United States, we have various channels. In the United States, there's public channels that reach just a local metropolitan area. So there's various different channels, local channels for each metropolitan area. And so we have in Massachusetts and in Connecticut, two states, we have some local channels that are broadcasting our content. And we have here on the table the city and the state and the channel that can be watched in that city, where you can watch the program announcing the eternal gospel. So reiterating here what Pastor Jiduchi already mentioned, it's the work of the Lord that's being broadcasted in many places, opening to new frontiers, new countries. We're already sending content already also to Africa through radio. So, and there's also in Panama as well, for a radio station. We also have all our content in Spanish for Latin America as well. So it's the final moment that we're living in. It's the moment to preach the gospel and announce. And again, we're reiterating what Pastor Dutchy already mentioned. And you are part of this. And we'd like to, you know, remind all of our 0800 number here in Brazil that you can... It's not for the members of the Maranatha Christian Church. It's for those visitors. You know, the members are assisted by the pastors and the workers, but you can send this number to a visitor so they can call and receive assistance. There's a group of brothers in the presbytery receiving the calls, praying for the people, speaking of the love of God. This week we received a message of a person saying that they were going to even take their own life. They were badly intent, but the Lord has called us to a moment that the whole world is confined in their homes and socially isolated, but the Lord is giving us all these resources to evangelize, and He gave us this responsibility, you and I, to spread His word. And just reiterating also here, showing our social media pages, we are on Facebook, we're on Instagram, and also on YouTube, in the channel that you're watching right now. And I will repeat here, you have a marvelous instrument of evangelization in your hands, or you can send a link to the people that you love, people who you want the best for, that one day, you know, they got to know you and you got to know them. You can send these links, these channels, these pages to people who need the word of the Lord, who need the reach to reach the blessing of God in their lives. And you have the resource. God is giving you these resources to do what God awaits from you. Amen. So let's pray and put before the Lord this service. Lord, we praise you. We glorify you, Father, for your wonderful work. Lord, for the sweetness that is to participate in the service of worship to your name, the operation of your Holy Spirit, the marvelous way that you act in our lives, for this secret, this enigma, this riddle that was revealed to your church, the answer to our prayers. We praise you, and we ask that at this moment you receive in your altar this service, blessing each one of us, sending us on our way, but not away from your presence, living your blessing and having experience with you, and that tonight we can return to be here at your feet again to receive your portion. And we ask that you receive on your altar the service, and in your name we say that the marvelous grace of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ, love of God our eternal Father, and the sweet and eternal consolations of the Holy Spirit can rest upon you and all the people of God now and forevermore. Amen. Praise be the name of the Lord. And to you who watched this Sunday Bible School, I'm inviting you in the same channel right after or later today at 8 p.m. local Brazil time for a service. And peace of the Lord Jesus to all. May God bless you.